second spasm. Scrapbook of prophecies, head full of dreams. Coat made of leather, but no thread in the seams. Pair of boots let it rain. Back on the road again. Rusty old strings on a broken guitar. Dusty old seats in a dirty old.
Me and you.
and her tears, she would say, he was told, there's his picture on the wall, my old great aunt, Margarita, she'd been blind 30 years, she would ask, is he smiling? I would stare at the frame, but the sun was there shining through her window again, where that sun always shone, he had faded and gone, but she would ask, is he smiling? I would say, he's the same, it's sending word, Margarita, we'll build when it's through, in that new world, Margarita, we'll be wed, me and you, there blame. Margarita, dance it this last time with me. It won't be long, Margarita. Soon I'll be overseas. Let me know that you care when I've gone over there. They're playing our song, Margarita, dance at this last time with me. True story about my great aunt. This is a song that refers to my grandmother, Grandma Pierce. We lived with her for a short time. When I was very young, until she sold us her house and emigrated to New Zealand at the age of 60. As a widow, she was chased on the boat all the way over by two widowers, and eventually she finally chose Ed and got married and had a wonderful life there in New Zealand, swimming in the sea until she was in her 90s. Had a complete other life of over 30 years with Ed. Marvellous. She sent all these wonderful letters back and her daughter followed. She got off the boat, she married a bloke she met on the boat. These were journeys that took 6 to 7 weeks via Pitcairn Island. So there you are, ladies, it's never too late. But don't take a 2-week cruise. 6 to 7 weeks, you'll grab somebody. When we lived with Gran, she always used to say, I'm going to get to our age, you realise what that phrase means, feeling under the weather. Do you know what I mean? Some days you just do feel under the weather. And whenever Gran felt like that, he said, you're right today, Gran, she'd say, it's the Arthur Itis. And when I was a young kid, I always wondered who he was. That coming down the street, it's Mr. Arthur Itis. Someone you don't want to meet is Mr. Arthur Itis. He's a drag, he's a pain, seems to come out with the rain. I wish he'd bugger off again, Mr. Arthur Itis. Don't shake hands, don't say good day to Mr. Arthur Itis, 'cause won't go away, Mr. Arthur Itis. Don't you stop, don't give in. If you do, he'll always win. You'll want to stick your ibuprofen, Mr. Arthur Itis. He's no fun, he's no joke, he's a really nasty bloke. Someone you just like to choke is Mr. Arthur Itis. No one gives him any points, Mr. Arthur Itis, 'cause he hangs out in crummy joints, Mr. Arthur Itis. So if he comes down your way, pray he doesn't come to stay. And if he leaves, shout, hooray! Piss off, Arthur Itis. All together now. If he leaves, shout, hooray! Piss off, Arthur Itis. Doing this, and now I got audiences singing piss up. I think it's great. You know, it makes me laugh. We just had this election and everything, and now we're in an unholy mess with a sort of fundamental Tory government. We're going to screw us all over. And I'm amazed when they're interviewed. Any politicians interviewed on the TV or whatever, they're always so surprised that the baby boomers are now beginning to wash up on the shores of the National Health Service. You see it in their faces. Where are they coming from? We had no idea they were there. Bastards. I knew we were coming for 60 years now. You knew we were coming and you told us how. You'd greet us and treat us and keep every vow, 'cause you knew we were coming for 60 years now. Yes, you knew we were coming and we need your care. You knew we were coming, we all paid our share. But what we all dreamed of is now a nightmare. But you knew we were coming, and we need your care. We are the babies you counted and grew, the boomers who've worked all our lives just for you, for your golden handshakes and your knighthoods too. And now we're demanding you give us our due. Yes, you knew we were coming, Maggie and Ted. Lord Hume and Wilson and Callaghan said there'd be a doctor, the drugs and a bed, 'cause you knew we were coming, Maggie and Ted. Yes, you knew we were coming, and now we are here. Be patient, you tell us, but one thing is clear. Patience wears thin when there's hope and there's fear. But you knew we were coming, and now we are here. We are the babies you counted and grew, the boomers who've worked all our lives just for you, for your golden handshakes, your expenses too. And now we're demanding you give us our due, 'cause now we're arriving, the glad to be grey. We're the kids of the 60s, don't stand in our way. We marched before, now we'll have our say, 'cause now we're arriving, the glad to be grey. And you knew we were coming for 60 years now. Yes, you knew we were coming, but you never said how. You cheat us, defeat us, and break every vow. But you knew we were coming, and here we are now. Yes, you knew we were coming, and here we are now. away all the hours. The pictures are ragged and brown. Could that really be me, looking young and feeling free, marching my own into town? We played in the cool water fountain. We danced with the blind and the lame. Bruce Davies did all the arrangements and helped me produce the album up there, did some amazing work on it. He's a brilliant, brilliant musician. I hate him. I absolutely hate him for it. He can do all the stuff I can't do. And he did it on the album, played brilliantly. And I was doing the sound check tonight, and he strolls. He and his wife come down from Scotland, from Fife, just to see the gig tonight. And so I'd like to get Bruce up on stage, and he and I would like to do some songs together, one or two from the album that I can't play, but which he can. So, ladies and gentlemen, would you welcome Mr. Bruce Davies? He and I have grown up in parallel with them, and one of the ones that really started us off was Mr. Tom Paxton. You all know Tom, I take it?
Yes.
And so, to loosen us up and to introduce you to Bruce and his ability, we'll do one of Tom's songs and join in. Go. Of a tape a guy had got of Graham and I working together in Iserlohe in Germany, at one of the Forces folk clubs, 1974-1975, and I played it. It's absolutely brilliant. And I was saying to Wendy, I said, I so miss having somebody up on stage with me and somebody to work with, and, you know, because it's such a joy to bounce off each other and all of that. And he turns up. So, thanks, Graham, wherever you are. It's appreciated. Now I'm going to try and remember the words to these songs, which I haven't sung since we recorded them. Oh, there's a challenge, isn't it? Yes, we're in trouble here, mate, I tell you. Do you know them? No, right. And we didn't put a booklet to the words in this one, did we?
No, I
did we?
No, well, no, we didn't.
We didn't?
No.
We did?
Yeah.
We didn't.
We didn't.
Oh, solid.
This is Harvey's story, but I think it's everybody's story that got a guitar early in life and maybe just dreamed of it.
Oh, do I start? All right. I love this guitar, although I don't play it well. I'm just not a Ralph McTell or a 40 chord star, but I love this guitar. It knows every song I sing, be it trad, be it western swing, be it doobie-doo-wah. I love this guitar. When we plied the trade of the old troubadour, and if I had my time to live over again, I'd say I'd do it again this way. I'd take the encore, 'cause I love this guitar. Though it isn't the first I played, that was cheap and Korean made from a Christmas bazaar, but I love that guitar. Tune it right, I played it day and night, in hopes I'd go far. I love that guitar. Then I found a special one, a Gibson I reckoned on, and desired from afar. So I bought that guitar. It was red like a blazing sun, and together we played for fun, for drinks at the bar. I love that guitar. And it carries the scars from all of the gigs we play, the nights when we plied the trade of the old troubadour. And if I had my time to live over again, I'd say I'd do it again this way. I'd take the encore, 'cause I love this guitar. Play it well. I'm just not a Ralph McTell or a 40 chord star, but I love this guitar. It knows every song I sing, be it trad, be it western swing, or a doobie-doo-wah. I love this guitar. I love this guitar. I love this guitar. Are you ready? Well, I think I'll take another crack, said Whiskey Jack. Sneak another season on the road. Miles are getting longer, days are growing dark. I'm tired as the stories I've told. The posters have my name, it's second billing now. Chorus that I sing, nobody knows. Empty seats fill quickly when I leave the stage. Carrying the lines the spotlight shows. And they always make me feel so down when they question with a frown and know that face. And the kids all say that's Whiskey Jack in a voice that echoes like a smack across my face. The girls I knew are married and much wiser now. Numbers in my notebook never ring. Those that come to call leave just an empty glass. Empty eyes are all they seem to bring. And they always make me feel so down when they question with a frown. I know that face. And the kids all say that's Whiskey Jack in a voice that echoes like a smack across my face. So I think I'll take just one more crack, said Whiskey Jack. Sneak another season on the road. Drag my fading daydreams through familiar towns. Tell again the stories I have told. La 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 la
My wife and I are very friendly with an absolutely amazing violinist, fiddle player, orchestrator, whatever. And she came in to do the session, and Harvey was trying to describe what he wanted, and Shona was just getting started. And well, can I mention the word? Harvey was orgasmic. Just
watching. And at 72, that makes me very happy.
So it really was very special.
Now, our friends from Holland who've come all the way for this gig, this is another song you requested. And again, I used to do it with Graham when we made the Friends of Mine album. So Bruce is going to take the lead on this, and I'm going to do the harmonies. Are you happy with that? Okay, we'll give it a go.
To me, I will never have the words to let them know just how.
This is Bruce's impression of Martin Carthingham. Bloody perfectionists. I'm tone deaf anyway.
You've got an expression for that in Scotland. Aye, right.
One of the songs I was going to record for the album wasn't working, and I knew it wasn't working, he knew it wasn't working. And there's always a song that doesn't work. Every album I've gone to make, there's always one song that for some reason isn't working, and you've got to have backup. Well, this album used up all my songs that I had recorded, the ones I thought were good enough, and we were a song short. And I said to Bruce, I said, do you know? And he said, yes. And I said, let's try it. And we went through it, and it was hopeless. I couldn't sing it because I kept choking on it, because it's one of my all-time favorite songs. And I just kept blubbing away. And about three times, we had to stop because the emotion of the song just was wiping me out. It probably will tonight. If it does, I'm sorry, we'll stop and start again. But that's how music gets me, you see. It's the emotion. It's the passion and the power of words. It's not so much melodies for me, it's words, images. That's what's driven me for all these years. And this guy who wrote this is now a friend of mine, I'm glad to say. Stayed with me when he came over here. His name is David Mallett. He is my favourite living songwriter. If you don't know him, go and find him. Dave is very similar to me. He comes from Maine in America. He writes about where he lives, he writes about some of the farming life around there. Oh, you've got to make hay while the sun shines, that's what the hill people say. He writes sort of country-tinged folk, but lyrically, he is the most literate, I think, of all the American songwriters that I know. And he's in his late 60s now. And he's had hits, and he's been recorded by loads and loads of really famous people, which I haven't. I can boast Max Boyce and Mary Hopkin. Mind you, I did get a number two in New Zealand. Number two in the charts. First, Three Dog Night. Second, Harvey Andrews. Third, Elton John. Fourth, Rod Stewart. Fifth, The Kinks. Second in New Zealand, number two. Yeah. 84 copies. So I have to have the lyrics with me just to remind me, because I don't want to screw this one. But Dave's most well known in America for writing a song that everybody recorded. Arlo Guthrie recorded it. Who else did it? John Denver recorded it. Yeah. And it's for a simple little song. We'll do a couple of verses now. See if you remember. This might be
it's used. Never even done.
No.
Never.
It's used in schools, isn't it? All over the world. One, two, three, four, right. Rock, do that again. I'm ready now. Inch by inch, row by row, gonna make this garden grow. All it needs is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. And inch by inch, row by row, someone bless these seeds I sow. Someone warm them from below till the rain comes tumbling down. Dave Mallett, go and find him.
Yeah, worth it. Definitely.
You can YouTube him. There's some great videos of him singing on YouTube. He's a bit like me. He sort of falls between the cracks. He's not quite folk and he's not quite pop and he's not quite country. He's just too bloody good for any of them. Am I right?
I would say so.
Here is my favourite Dave Mallett song, his favourite Dave Mallett song. Ah! Didn't we put it up one more?
No, that was it.
That was it, are you sure? You sure? I think you should. I might be wrong. If it is, I'll stop and go back down. You're right. I like this busking business. If you're free, we can play in the Shrewsbury Arcade, you know. In the shade of this old tree, in the summer of my dreams, by the tall grass, by the wild rose, where the trees dance as the wind blows, as the days go so slowly, as the sun shines oh so holy on the good and gracious green, in the summer of my dreams, by the banks of this old stream, in the summer of my dreams, by the deep pool where the fish wait for the old fool with the wrong bait. There's a field of purple clover, there's a small cloud passing over, and the rain comes washing clean on the summer of my dreams. See the raindrops on the grass now, just like diamonds lying there, by the old road where I pass now, there's a twilight in the air. And as the sun sets down before me, I see my true love waiting for me, standing by the back porch screen, in the summer of my dreams. available for my wife at the table through there after the show. You can't follow that, can you? It's just... That's a great, isn't that a great song?
Yeah.
Beautiful. The nicest thing is, I sent it to Dave, and there must, I think there's something like 40, 50 different artists recorded.
There's a lot, and I'm chuffed with this as well. I know what Harvey's going to say.
And he emailed me back and he said, that is the best version ever. And that meant more to us. Of course, he's an American, so you know they always say.
I met Dave, and he would not say that.
No, he's not. Lovely guy. Do find Dave Mallett. Google him. Well, we'll finish with this now, because I'm completely emotionally drained by that. I always am. God, I wish I could write like that. Too slow, Bruce! Too slow! Unfortunately, I write like this. So, thank you ever so much for coming this evening, guys. We've enjoyed it. Roger Davies, ladies and gentlemen, the great one. Related, but we haven't done a DNA test yet, but this is Bruce Davies. Here we are. And ladies and gentlemen, this is Harvey Andrews. Absolutely fed up with the driving. It was just getting worse and worse and worse. The roads are just so clogged. When I started, the M1 wasn't finished. Of course, it still isn't. But that's not the point. And I said, I've never come this far again. 163 miles to get here. But, you know, it's been worth it, and we hope you've enjoyed it as much as I have, Bruce has. So, join us in this chorus. See if you recognise this driver, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, it's not you people smiling that worry, it's you bastards frowning. I know you! It is now a punishable offence. The police can stop you. They've only prosecuted one, I think, in 18 months or something. I mean, if I was a copper, they would go, I'd go. I want them all arrested. I want them and their cars taken to the nearest ferry port. I want them taken across the channel, through Holland, to the German border. I then want them placed on an autobahn. And believe me, within 5 minutes, they will know what the inside lane is for. You ever driven in Germany, Bruce?
Yes.
Oh, isn't it wonderful? It is. They know what they're doing, don't they?
Exactly.
Yeah. Say more. Try the chorus, please. I'm driving in the middle lane. Driving in the middle lane. Not too fast, not too slow. That's the way I like to go. I never use the inside lane. I never use the inside lane. You can flash, you can toot, I don't give a hoot, I'm staying in the middle lane. You No one on the inside lane. Everybody in the middle lane. Going back mile after mile after mile. Oh, that's my idea of heaven. Especially when I'm towing me caravan. And driving in the middle.
Some of the words have sort of taken on different meanings over the years.
This was in my repertoire in 1965. Really? While I was still learning to write myself, yeah. I sang a lot of Tom's songs. Yeah. But I never sang harmony with myself.
No, it's
a... I tried, but I ended up in hospital. Well, you can do the harmony. No, you know the words. I'm playing safe now.
Some ladies are foolish, some ladies are gay, some ladies are comely, some live by the bay.
My lady is a wild flying dove, my lady is wise. She whispers each evening, she's mine, mine, mine. She likes pretty pictures, she loves
she's
while flying low.